A Time to Keep. The Tasha Tudor Book of Holidays. Written and illustrated by Tasha Tudor. Time is the image of eternity. Plato. Where beauty has no ebb, decay no flood, but joy is wisdom, time, an endless song. William Butler Yeats. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to keep. Ecclesiastes. Granny, what was it like when Mummy was me? January. January brings the snow, makes our feet and fingers glow, Mother Goose. Oh, there were lots of joyful times. On the last day of the old year, the children built a bonfire. We all danced around it and shouted, Happy New Year! Then we had a party supper with roast beef and Yorkshire pudding and apple pie and ice cream and cheese. January 6th, the 12th night, the children took out the 4 goat sleighs and had races. It was great fun. There was a prize for the winner. In the evening, everyone dressed up and played charades. February. Roses are red and violets are blue. Angels in heaven know I love you. Old song. We had a small post office in those days. Valentines came by sparrow post. The Dow family received valentines. So did all the corgis. And Miss Puss got a catnip mouse. On Washington's birthday, we had Washington pie for tea and favors sent from Boston by Aunt Middle Mary. In the evening, the children put on historic tableau using the costumes we still had in the attic. March. Daffodils that take the winds of March with beauty. William Shakespeare. March brought sugaring weather, and everyone turned out to gather sap. Syrup making ended with a sugaring off party when we ate dinner at the sugar house and had sugar on snow for a treat. April. April showers bring May flowers, Mother Goose. Easter week, we all made pretty Easter eggs and had hot cross buns for tea. We always had the most wonderful Easter egg tree with goose, duck, chicken, bantam, and pigeon eggs. On the top were the canary eggs. In April, the new kids were let out to play in the warm spring sunshine. There were calves to feed and little chicks, and there were always gaggles of goslings. May. Welcome be thou, fair, fresh May, Geoffrey Chaucer. On May Day, the children left May baskets at our neighbor's doors, and we danced around a maypole. That's the month we planted the garden. We had delectable 11-ish parties with iced tea and cookies under the crabapple tree. June. And it was summer, warm, beautiful summer, Hans Christian Andersen. Midsummer's Eve comes in June. That's when we had marionette show. There were many, many rehearsals. Marionettes to make, scenery to paint, and programs to print and color. The play was at night in the carriage shed. Grandmother's had the very best balcony seats. Refreshments were served at the intermissions, and everyone had a wonderful time. July. Life, Liberty, and the Pursuit of Happiness, Thomas Jefferson. July 4th started with the setting off of firecrackers under tin cans. The boys loved the noise, but the corgis didn't. We would hang the flag from the loft window and fix a huge, delicious picnic. Then we would take the canoes and paddle to the Magic Island where we ate lunch. In the evening, there were fireworks at the fairgrounds in the village. We liked to watch them from the high pasture. August. My heart is like a singing bird. Christine Rossetti. August brought your mother's birthday, which we celebrated at night by the river. The table was set with birch bark plates and gourd drinking cups. There were favors made from walnut shells and families of wooden animals in little baskets and meringues made in the shape of toadstools. But best of all, the birthday cake came floating down the river. September. Comfort me with apples, Song of Solomon. September is fair month. On Labor Day, we used to hold the dolls' fair. All the dolls came, of course, and their friends. We used buttons for money. You could buy cakes and pies and everything else you wanted, all for buttons. It was great fun. There was a flower and vegetable show with prizes, beetle races, archery contests, and delicious ice cream sodas. October. When the frost is on the pumpkin and the fiddler's in the shack, James Whitcomb Riley. October was a time to make cider and pumpkin moonshines. And what exciting Halloween parties we had. November. No fruits, no flowers, no leaves, no birds. November. Thomas Hood. On Thanksgiving, we roasted a turkey before the fire. So many relatives came to visit that the children had to sleep in the barn. We did plays and charades and had literary contests with a handsome book for first prize. That's the month we made Christmas presents and a year's supply of candles. December. Some say that ever against that season comes wherein our Savior's birth is celebrated, the birds of dawning singing singeth all night long. William Shakespeare. Christmas was the best of all times to keep. On December 6th, St. Nicholas's birthday, we put up the Advent calendar and the Christmas pyramid. We lighted the Advent wreath and had a St. Nicholas cake for tea. Christmas Eve was a magical time. When dark fell, we stepped into the starlight night to follow a winding path lighted by candles to an enchanting crash in the woods. And on Christmas night, we had the loveliest celebration of the year, with a beautiful tree in a shine of candles to remind us of peace on earth and loving kindness. And that's how it was when your mother was a little girl.